Usually, when it comes to renewable energy sources, our thoughts turn to wind, photovoltaic, geothermal energy. But we must also remember bioenergy. We can stock wood for months, even years if necessary, and reuse it later on. This is not possible with other renewable energy sources, such as solar or wind. That's why biomass is a very interesting source with a considerable potential. Of course, bioenergy by itself cannot solve energy and climate issues, but it can certainly make a contribution, which can be more or less significant depending on country-specific conditions. The Proforbiomed project was intended to evaluate the potential of this sustainable and renewable energy source in the Mediterranean countries, where the supply chain that involves, first of all, the management of the woods, then the management of the fuel and of the energy plant, is less developed than in Central and Northern European countries. People often believe that the cutting down of trees from forest land is a bad thing in any case. Every time that a flood or a significant landslide occurs in Italy, the news immediately blames deforestation, which is not the problem. In Italy, since the Second World War, the forest area has doubled. And from the beginning of the 20th century, it has tripled. The problem is not deforestation. On the contrary, it's the abandonment of the territory, which has created conditions that are not suitable for the human activities carried out in downstream towns. We can start from what seems to be a commonplace, but actually portrays the real Italian forestry situation. We have gone from being a country poor of woods to being a rich country with poor woods. In other words, one-third of the Italian territory is covered by forests, but generally they're very poorly and badly managed. As an indication, exploitation for energy purposes affects about 70% of total forest land, and the rate is rapidly growing. It means that our forests are increasingly used for firewood or other products intended for energy production. An opposite trend compared to other European countries. The latest estimate in a study provided by the Italian Association for Agroforestal Energies talks about no less than 27 million tons of firewood, wood chips and pellets consumed, against a domestic production of about 7 million, showing therefore an absolutely relevant gap. Bioenergy already produces a substantial supply to the domestic energy demand, contributing about 3 to 4%. It's difficult to make an assessment because of the lack of reliable official statistics. Actually, the biological potential of natural resources is much higher. The contribution of bioenergy may reach 10 to 12% of the Italian energy demand. To bridge this gap, we must adopt policies, strategies and measures to optimize the energy resources. There are two roads to be taken for the development of bioenergy. One road entails the development of the so-called production chains, the other one, the cascade use of wood resources. The concept of the cascading approach for the use of wood has emerged strongly in recent years and is mentioned in several documents and initiatives at national and especially European level. Just to name one, the 2013 European Forest Strategy strongly refers to this concept. What is this concept about? Basically, it's about promoting an efficient and rational use of wood resources, simply allocating the material taken from the woods according to the most natural end use, compatible whenever possible with the highest added value. Trying, therefore, to prioritize the industrial and processing use of wood, using only residual waste and byproducts for energy purposes. The cascade approach could be included in the broader concept of a short production chain, where the adjective short does not refer only to the geographical distance, but also to the model of forest management related to the wood supply. Beyond doubt, the development of local supply chains has several potential positive impacts, also from a socio-economic perspective, in terms of employment opportunities in the field and also in satellite activities. In particular, the role of forest logging companies, for example, could be somehow revisited so that the company does not only cut wood and sell raw material, but could also sell directly energy or contracts for energy supply. There are also various good examples, good practice cases in Italy. First of all, I'd like to offer some data on the forest system of the Lombardy region. There are about 620,000 hectares of woodland, about one-third of the territory, a pretty remarkably large area. It's divided into a privately owned area, highly fragmented and mostly abandoned, and a public property area, belonging to municipalities. They are mainly mountain towns with an extended territory, few inhabitants and an inadequate technical office, therefore experiencing great difficulty in management. We feel a bit the lack of a system as a whole in Lombardy. As an example, in Alta Valtellina, there is a very important district of sawmills where approximately 15% of national sawn material is produced. Almost all of the raw material, however, does not come from the forests just behind the sawmill, but from woods located a few kilometers away across the Swiss border. This happens because the sawmill needs certainty and continuity of supply. So, not so much for a question of price or quality, but of continuity of supply, something that only a well-established system can guarantee. In Switzerland or Austria, such an established system has existed for decades, if not centuries, and even the non-experts are aware of the importance of forest cultivation, not only for those who live in the mountains, but also for people who live far more downstream. The first examples of such a solution can also be found in Italy, with very positive results. Certain good practices can be implemented by those who work in the territory. For example, in the mountain community of Valsassina, which is not characterized either by any orographic peculiarity or by a remarkable forest, there are active institutions and skilled people able to make concrete proposals to other institutions, the region and the territory. Our mountain community was established by the Lombardy region in the 1970s. So we have now about 40 years of history behind us. An average community which stretches over a territory that is both mountainous and lacustrine and incorporates 28 municipalities. The forests of the mountain community cover approximately 60% of the territory, that's about 21,000 hectares. Forest management is based mainly on coppice and coppice with standards. Here, the chain of production is made especially of forestry companies and individuals who cut mostly firewood. The mountain community is the competent authority for forest management in the mountain areas. Until about 20 years ago, it was the Forest Service, which now has a supervisory role, while we have a programming and planning role. There are also about 20 active forestry companies equipped for this kind of management, thanks also to the promotional activity carried out by the mountain community. Aware of the potential benefits, the mountain community offered its own facilities and technical assistance to support business startups, also through funding from the Rural Development Plan. These policies have certainly promoted a higher level of forest wood removal. The mountain community is very active in forest management and has offered great support to the growth of forestry companies through various initiatives, sometimes hosting professional courses, sometimes organizing events related to technical machinery or related to the territory and local products, so as to include as many people as possible. There's a lot of general interest. We have often organized courses for hobbyist foresters with remarkable success, with hundreds of people participating. There are many opportunities for the creation of new businesses for young people, especially in view of the economic crisis that is also gripping our area. We have several young people active in this field. In about 15 years, the forestry companies have increased from a few to 15 today, and all these enterprises have enough work. Initially, I studied agriculture and became a land surveyor. I thought of dedicating myself to agriculture and created my own company. I started with a few cows, but this alone was not enough. So I began to fill my free time cutting wood for fire. I started a bit by chance with a tractor and a winch. Then I bought a digger, and last year I made big progress. I invested into purchasing a cable car and a new tractor. So the forestry activity grew and has now overtaken the farming one. Also, young people want to take up a challenge, probably because they realize that there are not so many alternatives in this time of crisis, and therefore the field of forestry offered them an opportunity. The wood worked here is almost exclusively beech wood, therefore used as firewood. We supply warehouses that will later sell to retailers and also many private citizens. We manage about 1.5 to 2 million tons a year. The company was founded 15 years ago and has slowly grown, also acquiring new equipment. It turned into a family business when I started to work with my son. There are various critical issues related to the lack of roads in secondary valleys. Purchasing machinery is also a problem, because often cable cars and tractors are very expensive. We first started only with hand working. Afterwards, we equipped ourselves, getting a winch and then a cable car. Now, we're going ahead in this direction. Another issue is the competition of illegal companies in the field of firewood, which is the main sector of the industry. Critical issues are things like danger in the workplace, unfair competition of companies selling timber illegally. In a few words, these are the main problems. Who are the main actors in the supply chain? First of all, the forestry enterprises, which are about 250 with more than 1,000 employees. Then there are the processing companies, such as sawmills, home furnishing and interior design companies, which flourish in Lombardy. So we start from the trunk, when we can, from a local trunk. When we don't have local trunks, we get them from Swiss or Austrian forests. We import the trunk, we deposit it in the service area, then we turn it into timber boards and leave them outdoors from 10 to 12 months to age. We transform the wood board into a square semi-finished product which stays a further 15 days in the desiccator to remove all the moisture. And then, depending on the kind of manufacturing, it is processed in milling machines or lathes, where it is further transformed to become a handle for a tool. It could be a hammer, a hoe, a pick, mainly a handle for building or an agricultural tool. In this sense, forest certification ensures the proper management of the forest from which the wood comes, and then the traceability with chain of custody tracking of the material. We've been certified for 10 years. Every year we undergo a certification authority audit. It checks that there's no mixing between normal material and certified material to guarantee the traceability of the forest from which the product originates. We feel that there is high demand in this field because the manufacturer wants to know if the wood comes from a well-managed forest or not. Data provided by the National Institute of Statistics, referred to 2011, shows a growing trend in the production of biomass for energy use against a decrease for industrial use. Our forests provide more and more firewood or other products intended for energy purposes. The return to the enhancement of the forestry industry, timber, energy, resulted in a growth of the forest utilization. The wood can be used as fuel in three forms: blocks of wood or logs, as in the past, or it can be cut into small scales, the so-called wood chips, or it may be reduced into a sort of compacted sawdust to form the so-called pellets. These are three forms of the same fuel with different characteristics when used in a combustion plant. All the waste from sawmills and wood-turning lathes is transformed into a very fine sawdust and then passed in a press for the production of pellets for combustion purposes, to be used in stoves or furnaces, depending on the need. The wood chip supply chain is developing. There are a dozen plants in the valley using wood chips, including ours. Gradually, new ones are starting up. There's also a local company that manufactures wood chips, and even a farm invested in a wood chip machinery to supply others. Our father was a lumberjack, so we already had the equipment. We were already in the field. And then one thing leads to another. We focused on this type of activity because there are fewer and fewer quality woods, and the ugly ones can be used to make wood chips are easier to take. We sell the high-quality timber to the sawmills or as firewood. The timber of poor quality instead is first piled up and then milled and afterwards delivered to power plants and used to produce electricity. This year we have already produced 350 tons with our material and more than 400 tons using wood coming from others, at a lower price because of the poorer quality of the material. This is the right way to enhance the poor quality wood because it's useful not only to cut material of good quality to make firewood, but maybe also to cut abandoned forests of chestnut or other woods of little value and try to transform it into wood chips for heating. Obviously, the choice between these three uses of biomass depends on many factors: the local availability of the material, the type of market developed in a certain area, the technologies that are used, and also on the type of management of the boiler or the boiler plant. We run a plant nursery company which produces seasonal plants and tall trees, both in the greenhouse and open field. We installed the power plant in 2008, as I'd been looking at these alternative energies for several years in a saving perspective, but also to shorten the production chain by reusing our waste material for energy purposes. We used to rely on diesel to heat up our greenhouses. The first year during the winter I had to buy material because the quantity I had was not enough, and I had a saving of 75%. I used to spend roughly 10,000 euros for agricultural diesel, and the first year, with 2,500 euros, I bought wooden material for the whole winter. We talk about residuals from pruning. We pile them up in our plant nursery, and then during the winter we mill them to make combustible, Once a year, I call the supplier for general maintenance. Then, if the material is of good quality, it produces very little ashes, and a cleaning every 2 weeks is quite enough. Sometimes we have savings on fuel orders of about 60 to 70%, and many times, in 3 or 4 years, the wood chip plants are paid back. Before, I used wood for general heating and diesel to heat the water. Since the price of diesel had been rising dramatically, I decided to install a wood chip plant. It provides heating and hot water to 3 apartments of 110 square meters each, at reasonable costs. There was immediately a kind of emulation, as other people realized that by choosing this kind of heating system, they could have improved not only their property, but also the whole territory. All the plants are equipped with filters, which practically do not allow the emission of fine particles. We're talking about high-performance plants, all certified and with great energy efficiency, reaching more than 90%. All fuel products are regulated by specific rules in Europe, and therefore the same rules in all European countries. These rules contain a classification of the most important parameters for the quality of the fuel. We can talk about real certification only for wood pellets. It's not only a product certification, it also checks the physical, chemical, and energy characteristics of the pellet and the entire supply chain traceability from the reception of raw materials to the pellet delivery to the final consumer. Currently, for firewood and wood chips, we don't talk about certification. In this case, quality controls are carried out on a voluntary basis by professional manufacturers. They generally make a sample of their product and bring it to reference laboratories, which issue a certificate of quality of the product. Biomass has two limitations that must be overcome through better management. It's a lower energy intensity fuel compared to oil and coal. So, a kilogram of wood contains less energy, 4 times less, than a kilogram of diesel fuel. Consequently, it takes a number of trucks, at least 4 times more, or even 10 times higher, compared to the number of trucks to transport the same amount of energy contained in a tanker. So, we need to optimize the transportation, the so-called supply chain, making it as short as possible, especially placing the end user's plants, whether domestic or commercial, as close as possible to where the material used as energy source is produced. Another problem is the air pollution related to human health and to the environment, because the combustion of biomass generates large quantities of toxic gases, as does the combustion of fossil fuels. However, in some cases, biomass can be worse. Fine particulate matter, the infamous PM10 or PM2.5 or sulfur oxides, are generated on equal quantity of energy produced in much greater quantities burning biomass than fossil fuels. There is a substantial difference between fossil fuels and bioenergy. The combustion of fossil fuels, such as natural gas, oil or coal, releases into the atmosphere the CO2 that has been locked for millions of years into underground geological formations. By contrast, the combustion of biomass returns to the atmosphere the CO2 absorbed by plants in more recent times. Suppose that the production cycle and the use of the forest resources are maintained over time, the carbon released will be re-sequestered when the forest regrows. In this way, the combustion won't cause an overall increase of CO2. But it's important to say that today we have new technologies, new plants that are able to break down these pollutants by a factor of 10, and in some cases by a factor of 100, compared to the old stoves, old fireplaces, old plants of past generations. Today, we can also control this aspect, which was the main critical issue related to the use of biomass. This makes biomass competitive compared to fossil sources, not only for the lower price, the simplicity of management, and for the fact that woods are often located in the same country and sometimes in the same community that use it, but also for the possibility of reducing emissions to acceptable levels. First of all, the project Proforbiomed was useful in understanding the real potential of the forest resources in Mediterranean Europe, beyond the biological value. It also helped to highlight the good practices in order to understand what are the best strategies, the more sustainable ones for the development of the so-called short rotation forestry plantations for the production of biomass for energy use. 4 years ago, an agreement called Pact for the Forest Wood Energy Supply Chain was signed by all the actors involved in the process, the owners, with subjects such as forestry consortia, forestry companies, processors, farmers associations, the federation that brings together the district heating companies, and so on. This group meets periodically to share decisions about the actions to undertake. But before that, it's an occasion to meet each other, exchange views, share needs and proposals. We've already seen that this system works well. Probably we have found a working synergy with the business world and the public world. Above all, we've become aware of the great opportunity that this sector can provide in terms of new jobs, especially in making the most of a potential and a resource like the forest, which exists in this territory from time immemorial and has always played an important economic role. Grandi spazi economici e commerciali.